André Schleifer, professor d'Economia a la Universitat de Harvard, va impartir la lliçó inaugural de la Facultat de Ciències Econòmiques de la UPF del curs 2017-2018, patrocinada pels laboratoris Doctor Esteve. Schleifer va ser guardonat amb la medalla John Bates Clark l'any 1999 i és un dels economistes més citats. La taula va ser presidida pel degà de la facultat, Walter García Fontes, per la vicerrectora de Projectes per la Docència, Cristina Gelpi, per José Luis Urbieta, en representació del grup Esteve, i per José Luis Pedro, qui va presentar el conferenciant com el Messi dels acadèmics. Schleifer va començar la conferència establint la importància que té el capital humà en el desenvolupament econòmic.
What I will try to suggest in this lecture is, I will go for it from the side, which is that an extraordinarily important, maybe the most important dynamic force behind development, behind growth, is what economic historians sometimes refer to as upper tail human capital. It's an idea that has been around economics, you know, for 200 years, that many people won Nobel Prizes for. And it's the notion that just like there is physical capital, like plants and equipment, there is also human capital, which is the stock of knowledge education that is embodied in people. I will show you that when we try to understand the sources of economic growth or the sources of economic progress, human capital appears to be the single most important factor, a single most important determinant of economic development.
A continuació, va argumentar en contra de la visió que l'última raó del creixement econòmic són les institucions i no el capital humà.
The strongest, most reliable predictor of economic growth over this period is the level of education. That is to say that countries that started with high levels of education actually have grown faster. The last four columns look at various rows, look at various measures of institutions, and what they show is that, in fact, depending on what you control for or don't control for, whether a country is a democracy, whether it has fewer or more constraints on the power of the executive, whether it's an autocracy, has not really mattered very much for economic growth and development. You have some very rapidly growing democracies, you have some very rapidly growing non-democracies, such as China, for example.
Per provar aquest punt de vista, Schleifer va utilitzar un exemple de l'època colonial, comparant dues àrees que havien estat colonitzades per missioners franciscans o jesuïtes.
So the colonial experience has been used by economists to look at this question of the determinants. Now, there are many, many papers on this. One of my favorite is actually based on a thesis, a PhD thesis, that was written here at UPF a few years ago, by Felipe Valencio Caicedo. And what he looked at is really quite an extraordinary experience in human history. So the little red dot there, red circle there, describes the area that we're talking about. So it's really the heart of darkness. It's one of the most remote and underdeveloped part of the world. Now what Valencio Caicedo looks at is a very interesting distinction, which is one between Jesuit missionaries and Franciscan missionaries. Now, the Franciscan got to this area first, and Franciscans, as you know, they are a mendicant order. They believe in tending for the poor and tending for the sick. They don't believe so much in things like education and training. The later order that arrives were the Jesuits, so they didn't get to go to the nicest places, they got to go to the less nice places, even among these remote places. And Jesuits, of course, was the order that was much more focused on education, on teaching skills, and various other things that would promote self-improvement. And so what Valencia Caicedo looks at is what is the level of economic development in these different villages, which were which were homes of different missions, the answer is that the places where the Jesuits went and the surrounding places today are looking much, much better.
A continuació, va presentar un article del jove acadèmic Simon Jagger en el que defensa que com més elevat sigui el nivell educatiu d'una ciutat, millor viu el conjunt de la societat.
And it's pretty dramatic evidence of a spillover, which is to say, the more educated is a city, the better off are the less educated people who work in that city. That is to say, it's some suggestion that what when a city has an educated workforce, you know, think about Boston or Silicon Valley in the United States, that benefits not just the people who are part of that educated workforce, but it actually benefits everybody else who is working in that city.
Un altre exemple va ser la quantitat de subscripcions a la Gran Enciclopèdia Francesa del segle XVIII, representativa del nivell educatiu d'una àrea determinada.
Now, France in the middle of the 18th century is not industrialized, but it does get industrialized maybe 50 or 75 years later. And what you find is that the places where in the middle of the 18th century there were more subscriptions to the encyclopedia are the places that actually industrialized first, had more productive firms, more patenting activity. So what does this mean? Again, I'm not saying that subscriptions to encyclopedia cause growth. You know, that would be a very easy solution to all of the world's problems. I am rather saying that subscriptions to encyclopedia are a proxy for having an interest in knowledge, an interest in practical knowledge.
Schleifer també va utilitzar l'exemple de com un país tracta el correu postal amb adreces plausibles però no existents. A mode de conclusió, va recordar que el capital humà amb mal nivell d'educació és, segons ell, la raó última del creixement econòmic.
So that's what I have for you, and I hope what you take away from this is that human capital actually does matter. That it matters, everybody's human capital matter, but in particular, if you want to think about what kind of human capital matters for economic progress, the upper tail human capital seems to play a particularly important role. And more centrally, I want to say that this is not some kind of an elitist idea. But rather, what all the evidence indicates to us that we have is that the development of upper tail human capital, the development of uneducated entrepreneurs, actually benefits everybody and not just the elites. Thank you very much.